NotAgetOnline.com/LiveWire.
Now, Scott spent yesterday.
Yeah. I can see it.
Nesting.
Yeah, I can. He's
tweeting. He's putting pictures up on the internet. And
see, now, which we would have done if we had Twitter
that stuff, right.
Back
yeah,
during
so you
the,
got any problem with that?
I don't have a problem with it because, I mean, that's his, you got to get. You're married?
Yeah.
Yeah, his wife is watching.
Of course. He has
to do that. You trying to get him in trouble?
Not at any.
He is Shawshanked.
Now, did any of your buddies come over and help with
that? No.
Greg went over yesterday and helped Scott.
Because he works for him.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I forced him. Position.
I forced him to come over and help me. I had a big box that needed to be taken out of my car up into the second floor.
Greg is what was known as the house Negro.
That's great. There you go.
And I didn't go over there to fix a crib. I went over there to help him put together a crib, sweep up his kitchen floor, to put away his shoes that were in the living room, to take out the trash, to do the recycling, to break down all the boxes.
Scott's acting like he's the one pregnant.
I'll put him
in bedridden.
Take a look down.
Exactly,
he might be. Right. Look at that fat bastard.
Come on.
It was, look, we shared a wonderful afternoon.
He put you to work.
We had a couple of beers.
A couple. You got hammered.
What?
You got hammered is what you did.
What are you talking
you
about?
You got drunk, and you started to get, we split a six-pack, right? And then we went and got some drinks at JD's.
That was after all the work was done.
That was after all the work was done. But we were drinking
so
as
took you out like a guy should do for a buddy.
Right, to get out some food and some beer.
Which was great. Which was great.
And you're gonna bitch about it?
No, I'm not gonna bitch about it. Here's what I'm gonna bitch about because you
what
did
are you
get
bitching about?
Because you did get drunk. And I talked.
Okay,
to
so what? Sue me.
Okay. No, no one's suing you. No one's suing you. But I talked to Anderson last night. On my way back, just because I had called him earlier in the day, he was returning a phone call. And I mentioned that you had got drunk, and there was a common theme with your drunkenness that him and I have decided.
What's the theme?
You throw stuff at people.
Yeah, he's the worst at that.
It's ridiculous. I was walking down Canton, and he came across a piece of cement that was broken.
What?
And it was this big.
Oh, my God.
And he picked up the chunk that was this big, and he threw it at me as I was walking down, and I told that to Mike, and Mike said he did the same thing to him where he took off his boot, and Scott took his boot off, and he threw it at Mike. You gotta work on that.
Not sure you should be a father.
I was gonna tell you real quick.
This might become an issue.
Standing up and miming is not effective on radio.
but look, you got five cameras in here.
Okay, proceed.
Dean Edwards.
Even Dean. Because
he thought he got into it.
That's how I tell a story.
That's how he talks.
I was merely testing your reflexes.
What you gotta do is you gotta work on that.
But you do it to everybody? No. Really?
Why'd you throw?
Can we put it to the test?
That's like someone saying, "No, I don't snore."
That's exactly what it is.
Wait a minute, Scott. If this is true, we need you and I. I am taking you out. I'm getting you drunk. I'm buying all the drinks, and we're going to put that to the test. I want to see if you throw things when you get really drunk.
You threw things at people. That's the worst part.
That's
you're not just throwing. You're not skipping rocks.
First of all, it was you. I threw something at you. Okay, let's put this in perspective.
That's true too. And Mike Anderson, former producer of the 98 Rock Morning Show, was that when he was working with us as well that he was throwing stuff, Scott?
I don't know what that.
He
this is the first
remember.
I've heard of the boot and the this thing. And I don't,
well, do you remember throwing?
I didn't know there was a theme. I mean,
do you remember throwing cement at me last night? Do you remember that?
Yes, it was the broken tree. I want to get rid of that tree, by the way, Mayor. It's digging up my sidewalk.
Oh, my God. You're all... Well, let's,
I gave you the schedule.
Yeah.
No, this is something different. There's a tree that's like... Rip it up my sidewalk. Anyway,
so is the
let's
crib
get
together?
Back to the yes,
is
that's
the
what
crib
we're talking
is together?
About.
The crib doesn't fall apart.
The crib is together. It's lovely. I want to thank Greg for the.
Right.
We filmed it. We filmed it for the station.
I'm very good at that kind of thing.
Yeah, because a bunch of single dudes would have watched two men put a crib together.
Right. I don't know if you would have gotten through it had I not been there.
No, it was a two-man job.
I agree. I 100% agree.
I put the changing table together myself. That was a lot smaller, but a crib's it's big.
Yeah.
You need to one dude to hold something while you're...
A little annoying when you're trying to show me all the baby clothes and all the baby stuff. And I'm like, I don't give two flying
asses
about
that. You did not.
He did. He opened up the closet and showed me all these, end quote, and I will quote, cute outfits for his baby girl that's coming.
Turned into Vanna White.
Just like, Jesus Christ, Scott. Come on, man. We're two men drinking beers here. And
this one is frilly.
It's ridiculous.
Oh, my God, Scott.
Tell me how the theme of the room matches. He's got owl theme, so like there's like owls all over the room.
Owls are hot right now.
Owl always love you is one of the signs.
Oh, jeez, owls.
Owl always love you.
No, it wasn't.
Yes, it is. That's what it says.
It does not say that.
I'll be there for you.
I took a picture of it.
Take a picture. Read what
it said. It was so gay. I took a picture of it.
That's not what it said.
It's exactly what it said. Owl always love you.
I actually think that's rather clever.
And then if I remember correctly, when you first walked in your room, you said, oh,
that's cool. You got owls. You go, my sister has owls all over her classroom. That's
my
cool.
My sister's also a
the
female.
Coolest thing ever.
Yeah.
She's well, also my wife is ever. A female. Like, I did that?
What does that say? Read that out loud, please.
It says, owl always love you.
It's really, now, it's just a little ridiculous.
I don't want to listen. I don't want to say
that's exactly what it says.
I don't want to say that. I don't want to say that the texts are coming in.
Yeah.
But this is from Don and Kim.
Yeah.
You know Don and Kim.
I know Don and Kim. Sure.
He threw a starfish at me in the Bahamas
oh,
when
no.
he was drunk.
Oh wow.
Common theme.
Now
common
I'm not going to say who this is, but let's just say that she is from a Latin descent in a way.
Yeah.
He is the worst angry drunk in the world.
Oh.
Trust me.
Ooh.
That's not well. That's not true.
Really?
Yeah, you weren't a bad time. You were just dangerous.
I got five people in this room that I've been drunk around. And any of you consider me an angry drunk?
I haven't gotten drunk with you that often, and Lord knows I'm an
alcoholic. I would just think this person's probably been drunk around you.
Who is it?
Whoever that is, it's wrong.
Yeah.
I mean, I know.
Oh, that's who that's from.
There's a diff that's no. That's different because
I can feel the wind from the backpedaling.
I'm not backpedaling. I'm saying if you're drunk and then you get angry,
yeah,
is different than being an angry.
No, but
drunk.
A lot of people. No, it isn't.
Well, it depends on how long it takes to get you because you get angry quicker when you're drunk. That's where angry drunk comes from.
I want to call so bad right now.
Well, we're actually kind of out of time. We got to run.
I don't care. This will be worth running late. Because here's the deal. What happens is some alcohol can make people violent.
Yes.
Right. Now I'm not a violent, angry
drunk. It magnifies
drunk.
Your emotions.
Here's the three people you've drank with. This person.
Yeah.
Four people. Don.
Yeah.
Douche.
Yeah.
And Anderson.
Yeah.
And all
four of them have
anger.
Said picking up a cinder block and throwing it at someone is not.
I wasn't mad at you. I wasn't pissed off.
I personally can't find another reason for one to throw a cement block at somebody unless they're angry.
See, so I just like to throw things.
It says
different.
No, not
throw
angry.
People.
He just
people.
Likes to throw things.
Yeah,
oh, and I can do what I want to do. Okay.
Oh, no. We're going to find
you
out
can
who
call,
this is.
Dave. You can call Huber. You can call Selena. You can call... I mean,
well,
I know
Dave
I'm not
Dave and
an angry
Steve
drunk.
Are out because they don't remember most of their drinking sessions anyways.
I didn't get that drunk, so I remember Scott being drunk. He wasn't angry. He was just
okay,
dangerous.
I wasn't angry. See, there you go.
You were just dangerous. You can't
there's
go...
A
dangerous.
Difference.
You just can't
okay,
go throwing
okay, you're throwing a giant cinder block at his head out of anger.
Dean Edwards.
It was a goo. It was... We were
you
joking.
Don't know any of us, you know, personally.
This is what...
But
this
how
is
does exciting. This sound? How does this sound to you? Does he sound angry?
Tossing a cinder block kind of leans a little towards the...
If you knew Greg,
angst.
You would understand it.
There's no excuse.
Yeah, but what about the other three people that have chimed in?
I mean, did he work up from a brick? You know, like, how did
he
get
no,
to...
He came...
Hello?
Hey.
How's it going?
It's good. How are you, Mickey?
Excellent. Now, would you consider Scott out of control, drunk?
No, I was just kidding. He's not angry. He does like to throw things. That is a fact.
Now,
so,
does he throw things angrily, though?
No, it's mainly joking, because he did do... I was there when he did that to Mike. That was at our house, so...
He just took a boot off, and has he ever thrown anything at you when he's drunk?
No.
So when I threw the boot at Mike, it was... We were goofing around.
Did he hit Mike?
Yes, I think it did hit him, yes.
Did it injure Mike?
So he's an angry,
no.
Good aim.
I just think it's hilarious.
You're gonna hurt
that Scott is quantifying his throwing abilities while he's drunk.
No, I'm quantifying the fact that these are not things done out of anger. If I'm goofing around,
no.
It's
out of love.
Hey,
out of love.
By the way, we are talking
to... You can throw
to
something out of love? Why isn't that
100%.
Usually it's plush.
I've thrown my 6-year-old out of love.
Yeah.
Usually it's a teddy bear.
It's not like I'm winging something at somebody's head trying to inflict injury.
What is a cinder block coming at me? How is that not going to inflict injury?
You're different. I'm not talking about you. You're a different story,
you're different.
Of course.
That's different. Now, you have a beard. You're a Viking.
Right. I should say that we are talking to the future mother of
Why are you on the air right now? What
because
is going
I
on?
Asked her
yeah,
to be.
Chiquita.
It is the beautiful Chiquita. How you feeling, sweetheart?
I'm good. Thank you.
You're a little over a month away.
I know. It's crazy.
What are you, 36 weeks or something?
It's like 34. 4.
Yeah, wow.
You're not going to be one of those that once your kid turns a year, you're still going to be going, oh, she's 18 months.
Making everyone else do a math.
Amelia has a problem with everything.
No, I don't like that either. It's
so, okay, let me ask you. When your kid is in its 19 month, how old are you going to say it is?
I don't know. Like, I don't know how old she is. Just look at her. Whatever.
She's under 2.
She's whatever. Yeah.
She's a keeper.
Just look at her.
A little more than a year and a half.
Yeah,
yeah,
exactly.
I'm not going to do all that. I'm just going by what I have an app that tells me.
I have an app.
I have an app. I have a mommy app.
I do. And that's the only way I know. I wouldn't know.
It's the only way I'm going to have a baby is to have an app on my phone that is the baby.
If I didn't have the iPhone, I wouldn't have had.
Did Greg and I do a good job on the crib?
Yeah, did you see the crib?
It looks good, right?
It looks good. Thanks, Greg. Yes.
And we clean. See, she didn't even notice. We cleaned the whole house.
I did know. When I got
cleaned
home,
the whole house.
You were drunk.
I made Greg clean the whole house.
I was going to say, the sweeping and all of that wasn't you.
Okay. Just another text, and I'm not trying. I swear I'm not trying to start any troubles. But wait a minute. I think you might have a drinking problem because here it is.
Throwing problem.
No, apparently it's getting different because now it says, well, the first night we met, we ate dog food.
Oh, Lord. Where's I don't know.
What's wrong with that?
That's true.
Dean Edwards. Yeah. What's wrong with that?
It's for dogs.
First of all, it was a dog biscuit. It was probably for one
of hold up. They are did you hear that? She said, actually, it was probably a dog
biscuit.
Yeah,
because we've done that before.
Yeah, no. She's done
it. We've done that before.
So the baby has an exciting life
experience.
Gerber's dog biscuit.
Chiquita is about to give birth to little chihuahuas.
Now you know why I don't hang out and drink with you or whoever else, because you're no fun when you drink. If you're not eating dog biscuits and throwing boots at people's head, then you're not having fun.
You know what? Call me a bore.
Yeah. What do you do? Just sit there?
I like to laugh and drink and
eating dog biscuits incites laughter.
Chiquita, congratulations. Thanks for giving us some insight into Scott's alcoholism. We love it.
Yeah, no, he's not angry. He's actually really, he's a lot of fun, but he does like to get a little wild.
Is he whiny at home, though?
Am I whiny at home? What does that mean?
Is he whiny at home?
What does that mean?
In terms
we're talking about drinking. When he's drinking, he's happy and he doesn't bother anybody. He's not whiny. He doesn't do that to me, so.
Not anymore.
He knows.
I was just curious if you were whiny.
Whine about what?
I don't know, like, guys.
Wrap it up.
Wrap it up.
The grocery
store yet.
First of all, the night with the boot throwing, can we all say that that was a special night? That was like a...
every time you
spiraled
hang
out of control.
Him so drunk every time.
Justin was there. Justin threw up and had to spend the night in the second bedroom. Hey. I'm just saying, this wasn't just me. We were all kind of like,
was Uncle Vince there too? Was he puking and farting in the bathtub?
No, but it was.
No, he was actually. Yes,
our other buddy was there. He had to. I think he almost puked.
I'm mad. I wasn't invited.
Yeah, it was.
That was a night that it just got weird.
Dean,
hashtag
white people problems, in case you're following this.
What happened?
You were drinking the moonshine.
I didn't force anybody.
You brought moonshine out yesterday. Building the crib, you brought moonshine out.
Ooh.
Now, Chiquita, you know, Scott is very respectful of you and how you're feeling on the show and the process and the baby and everything. He really doesn't give a lot of details other than health and things going good and blah, blah, blah. But honest, can I ask you a few questions? You don't have to answer them.
We're running so late right
now. Yeah, but this is a good... settle down. This is your child. Do you think the child is going to look like you or Scott?
You know, I don't know.
But you are praying that it looks like you, right?
Well, yes, of course.
Okay, good.
But I have no clue.
You don't want a little girl with 5 o'clock shadow.
Yeah,
and a huge nose.
Yeah, 5-inch nose. And the last thing I want to... How are you feeling, like, body-wise...
No, I'm great. I'm not just saying it.
Enjoyed your pregnancy?
Yeah, it's been perfect. Knock on wood. It's been great. Right.
Don't you have to be at work?
Yeah,
I'm working.
But she doesn't have a guy that stands next to her with a flimsy wrist. With a flimsy wrist. All right, Chiquita, well, we love you, and good luck with the rest of the pregnancy, sweetheart.
Thank you. Take care.
All right, baby. Bye-bye. Hey, he won't tell me anything. Do you need anything for the baby that I could get you guys?
I'll think a couple of things and I'll call you.
Text me, seriously. Okay. Whatever you need, I don't care. Yeah, I don't care.
The expensive stuff. And
okay.
All right, baby.
Thank
Take
you.
Care.
Have a great day. Bye bye.
Living Nanny sweetheart. Comes to mind.
Ooh, lucky man. You are a lucky man, Scott Reardon.
98online.com.